it's myself, Jamie of GEOSynths, and we're back with another review. This time it's the sixth review, and we're using the Korg Prologue. So when it comes to the features of this synthesizer, it is quite a simple synth, really, when you think about it. It's great in terms of the voice count, either 8 or 16 voices of VCOs. But it also has a digital oscillator as well. So there's a fair bit you can do just in the oscillator section to create different tones and textures and to really mess them up with things like oscillator sync, crossmod, and the ring modulator. So it's solid, well made, it's got a nice shape to it. Quite an unusual styling, actually. I'm not usually that keen on mod wheels and pitch wheels and all that being at the top here. I much prefer them being on the left-hand side. However, that would have made it a lot bigger. And it's quite a big synth as it is. There's a fair bit of depth to it. And it's raised up so you can see it a little bit better, which I wish everyone did that, actually. The ADSR is full for both the amp and for the filter. LFO, sadly, it's only one LFO with only a few destinations, but we'll talk more about the LFO a little bit later on in the sound design section. The filter's a 12 dB filter with lots of resonance, which is great, but a little unusual choice for a polysynth because they generally tend to have 24 dB. You can get more types of sounds out of that, but I really like 12 dB filters. We've got the effects section where there's lots of cool effects going on, especially the modulated effects. They're really good, the choruses and so on. So everything you really need is on the front panel, but of course there is a menu system where you can go into and get into more finer control. So that's what we've got on the synthesizer. But if you kind of think about it, there's actually two synthesizers. So think of this panel once and then think of it again, because we can stack two layers together. We can also split or blend one sound into the other. There's an arpeggiator, which you can choose if it's going to be on one layer or both layers. And the same with the effects are a little bit like that as well. You can choose which layer what effect gets, because both of those layers are fed into the effect section. So it's a kind of global thing for both of those layers. There's not like a different set of effects for each layer. And for the workflow, in terms of workflow, it's really, really simple. Everything's in front of you that you need. It starts pretty much from the VCO section and moves all the way across, a bit of jumping around in the middle, but other than that, it's all just there. Some of the settings require the use of the menu system. So we have, for instance, the digital oscillator. We need to use that to go in and change a lot of the parameters. So for instance, we go into VPN, we've got the different types we can choose and we choose the shape of that. But if we want to go into even more depth, into the multi-engine section, then we've got other parameters like feedback, noise depth, shape mod, mod attack, decay, and key tracking. So there is a little bit of menu diving, but once you're there, it's only just pushing the button a few times. Of course, it is all done from a little tiny screen like that, which for my eyes isn't great, but at least it's all there for you. But like most synthesizers, because this isn't a very complex synth as opposed to other manufacturers, it's very easy for the muscle memory to, you know, learn all these different ways of making all these sounds, and you just learn it very quickly, I think, is the great thing. And of course, because you've got those two layers, you can just blend those together. So it's very quick to actually put things together. So what about the sound design of the Korg Prologue? So with everything, it all starts with an initialized patch that comes with quite a few of them. So each oscillator has three different shapes: saw, triangle, and square. And of course, each one can change their shape. So we can do that for both of the oscillators. And we can utilize oscillator sync. Select this to VCO2 and then int. Also featured is ring modulator, which I really love. It's a good way of creating those crazy types of tones, but even just for texture. So for instance, I have it on ring. So can create very slow changes of the sounds, a bit like how you'd use an LFO, for instance. Of course, we also have the digital oscillator. So if I just turn down oscillator 1 and 2, bring up the multi. Put it in noise at the moment. And there's different types, high, low, peak. Which is good if you want to create different types of sounds that have noise in there. So whether it's percussion sounds or things like, you know, making wind and stuff like that. When it comes to user waves, it comes with one called waves. And we can change the shape, but if we wanted to get into more detail, there is a button, which is second from last, and you can change the different waves within this wave table. So you choose wave A and wave B, and then use the shape, and you can just blend between them. There's also a subwave. So we go on to the next parameter, so we can bring in the submix. So right now we're blending from one wave shape to another. We've got it fixed at the moment with shape, but there's also a sub, but we can alter that shape with the LFO. It has a ring modulator as well. And a bit crusher. So I've just set up a quick LFO to the shape of the oscillator. So it's blending from, like, just getting the knob and going from one side to the other. Now the LFO is also changing the shape of the VCOs as well. You can actually go in and change what is being shape modded. But for now, we'll just leave it at the three. So there's a fair bit of tonal shaping going on, combining the VCOs plus the digital oscillator. Now, again, the LFO, there is just one of them, and there's only three destinations, and unfortunately, you can't use all three. You have to choose which destination. So it's kind of hardwired to a degree. So it's a little limited when it comes to that. It has slow, and it has crazy fast, Wave shapes, again, are saw, triangle and square. There's no random or sample and hold. And then there's BPM, lock into BPM. So even though the LFO does have some limitations, you can actually create some great textures with this synthesizer. And I think for me, that's where I found its strengths, is in soundscapes, pads, that type of thing. So another thing that it has is a very good set of effects, especially the modulation effects and the reverbs. They are very kind of eventide Strymon to a degree. This is a pad I made, which is using the type of shimmer effect, which I know is slightly being a bit overdone these days, but just take a listen. So yeah, when you buy the Korg Prologue, you don't need a Big Sky. some great, fantastic effects on here. And as I've said, I love effects. Effects are great. I'm not one of these, turn off the effects and let me listen to that raw oscillator. Nah, more effects the better. Thank you. Okay, so now I'm going to demonstrate just building some kind of pad from scratch. Get an init patch. Go to user, turn off oscillator 1 and 2, bring up multi. So it comes with waves, but there are additional ones that you can buy from third parties, which I've got quite a lot of them. FM monster, organism. Super saw. And these are good because they've got their own self-contained things like LFOs in there. Bring up a bit of attack, decay, sustain, release. We can choose whether that's going to be filtered or not, but I'm going to add a VCO. Maybe oscillator 2 and have that on a pulse. Photo shape mod. We'll have the LFO just targeting oscillator 1 and 2. Bit of velocity for the filter. Add a shape for filter envelope. So that digital oscillator really adds a lot. We can change the digital oscillator so it only goes, it bypasses that filter. So that kind of shape mod that's going through it all, both the VCOs and the LFO that's already in the digital oscillator, creates all this texture and movement. I mean, with a 12 dB filter, you're not going to get a nicey-nicey sound. It's going to be textured and rough. And then you can add whatever modulated effect that you want on there. So there is an ensemble. not the best in the world. I much prefer the chorus or the phasers. There we slap a bit of delay on. Delay type. Let's have tape. Get a bit darker with each repeat. So that for me, you know, that's a lovely sound. And of course, that's just one layer. So what about the dislikes I have for the Korg Prologue? Well, unfortunately, there's quite a few. Yes, no aftertouch. That could have been forgiven to a degree if it was a cheaper price, if it had more modulation, but the fact that there's only one LFO, and out of that LFO, you can only choose one destination. There's only three destinations, but you can only choose one. I mean, they should have had this as like a three-type knob. You can set pitch, add an amount, go to shape, add an amount, add cut off, add amount. That would have been better, but just only having one is, well, I don't quite understand that for these days. You know, we know from the smaller ones, like the monologues and mini logs, they've got the same sort of structure as one LFO, but it made up for it by having this sequencer that could record motion lanes. And it's like they thought, all right, we need to do an 8-1 or a 16 voice sequencer, right? How do we do that? It's going to cost us too much time. I don't know what. Let's just not do anything. But we'll still charge that high £1,700 price. And, you know, that's a little bit over the top, really, I think. Other things I don't like this use of tiny little screens. You know, if you're going to have a screen, let me see it, you know? It's nice having that little oscilloscope on there. But it doesn't really need that. What it needs is a bigger screen. Maybe even that section there would have been better. One of the biggest bugbearers I have with the synth, and it's for a lot of Korg synths actually, in that, and it's really from a sound designer's point of view, is that they don't use a bank system for the patches. It's either a case of you load one patch at a time or all 500. There's no bank A, B, C or bank 1, 2, 3. It's all or nothing. And that's a, you know, we've been doing this, synthesizers have been around for a long, long time now. So, come on, Korg. Okay, so let's start scoring the Korg Prologue. So when it comes to the features, there's the oscillator section is the saving grace a little bit from here. The filter's nice, but it's not a huge, you know, character to it at all. Having that resonance can bring out the high harmonics a bit. So, you know, the saving grace a little bit is that digital oscillator. That said, it's maybe not the nicest digital oscillator that I've heard. So I think in terms of the features, having 16 voices is great. Those two layers, that's what kind of makes up for it a little bit as well. But I don't think in this day and age, bearing in mind the competition and the price that it come out at, I don't think the features, it's not feature rich. So I'm going to give it 13 out of 20. And the score for the workflow? Well, workflow on it is very easy. You know, there's not a huge amount of controls, not lots of modulation routing where you can get like a little bit lost and head scratching and things like that. There's quite a lot going on here, all in the front panel. So for that, I'm going to kind of give it 14 out of 20 for workflow. When it comes to sound design, yeah, it does sound very good. You've got to really like that 12 dB filter, though. I personally do. I love those rough textures and then blending them together. There's not a huge range of sounds that you can kind of do, but it can be a very pleasing synthesizer to make sounds on. Yeah, I haven't really spoken too much about the low frequency compressor. To me, that's a bit of a gimmick. I would have preferred maybe even the tube from the King Korg. So for sound design, I'm going to give it, again, 13 out of 20. And for versatility, it's not the most versatile synth. I think it really sits for pads and textures, yeah, leads and things like that. It's not so much for big stomping bass sounds or anything like that. I think it's nice textures with those digital overtones. It can do things like electric pianos and all that type of stuff. I've done some good ones on here, but it's not as diverse as some of the synthesizers. So for versatility, I'm going to give it 12 out of 20. And for value for money? So when it comes to value for money, when it first came out, £1,700, and bearing in mind that we didn't have many new polysynths, you know, a few years ago, but of course, the ones that have come out really do beat it. And it does sound good, but I think when the price it came out at £1,700, it's just way over the top, really, for what it is, for what else you can get and the results you can get. No aftertouch, a 1LFO with only one destination is really pretty much unforgivable. It makes up for it with the digital oscillator and the 16 voices, but yeah. So value for money, I'm going to give it 11 out of 20. So there we have it for the Korg Prologue. It does make some fantastic sounds, but it's a narrow kind of niche. They cut a little bit too much from it and didn't implement enough in other areas either. It's a synth that is kind of lacking a little bit, and I worry that over a few years it will kind of just disappear into the background a little bit. It's a shame.